What we say is stop doing the interviewing and just open the doors. No questions asked. So what we think is if people start with a job, it's not important what they did before. It's what they do today and what they're going to do tomorrow. So if you ask questions about people, about what is your history, it's not relevant. Because somebody can decide for himself whether his history is relevant or not. And it's not for you to ask. So the open hiring is, come on, we are open. We hire the door. So who are we? Why is Start Foundation doing this? Start Foundation is a Dutch fund, and we are here, we're independent, that's very important to know. We're not part of anything, we're just a fund, we have money. And the only thing we want to do is get people to work. And that's our, it doesn't matter who it is, we want all Dutch people to get to work. We're a Dutch fund. And where do we come from? For the Dutch who are here, we are from Start Uitzendbureau. Once we were owned by government and also in some other parts. Anyway, Start Uitzendbureau was sold, and then the money came out of that is put in a fund. And now we can use it to get people to a job, which is a great thing to do. We can spend 130 million euros just to get people to jobs, which is very nice. And I'll introduce you to our managing director. He will tell the story.
Natuurlijk, in essentie zijn we een financier. Dat is onze basisfunctionaliteit, zeg ik altijd. Maar tegelijkertijd zijn wij ook natuurlijk de initiator van innovatie. We willen ook heel graag nieuwe dingen ontwikkelen. En we zijn onafhankelijk. En dat stelt ons in staat om ook langs instituties, langs de randen van de wet, allerlei dingen te doen die je eigenlijk normaal niet kunt doen. Dat is ook denk ik wel een beetje de Start Foundation. Laat het maar gewoon gaan doen. Weet je, schijt aan al die figuren die dan gaan roepen van kan allemaal niet en zo. Wij gaan gewoon een aantal pilots neerzetten. En dan gaan we eens kijken of het gaat werken. En dan laten we het maar zien.
Yeah, we did pick on a translation. Okay, so Start Foundation is this fund. We have several programs, and one of the programs is open hiring. So now you know. What is open hiring? Simply, no questions asked. If you think you can do the job, just show up. You get paid from day one, and you're not different from anybody else. So it's not a special program. It's not something, it's not like we say, oh, you get a chance, come here, show what you can. No, it's just like, okay, once the day you start working, you're just like anybody else, and you get the same treatment. So, we work together with Greyston, because you think it's a new idea. It is a new idea. In the Netherlands, it's a new idea in Europe, but it started in the United States years ago, and there is one company who's doing it for 35 years already, and they have a lot of experience. So we, Start Foundation got introduced to Greyston, and I'll introduce you to Greyston with a small movie.
Yep. Yonkers, New York. In de jaren 80 een van de meest criminele steden van de Verenigde Staten. Junks, prostitutie en straatroof. Een inwoner, Bernie Glassman, wilde daar iets aan doen. Hij begon geen opvanghuis of afkikcentrum, hij begon een koekjesfabriek. De Greystone Bakery, die brownies bakt voor Ben & Jerry's en uitgroeide tot een miljoenenbedrijf.
We don't hire people to bake brownies, we bake brownies to hire people.
What does that mean?
It means that our people is the core of our business. Helping people and giving people opportunities and jobs is the purpose of Greyston.
So that's a sort of mission?
Absolutely. It's our social mission. We actually have a triple bottom line. Our people being at the forefront, the environment, the planet, and then profitability, since we are a business. We typically hire people with barriers to employment. So that might mean a language barrier. That might mean that they've never had a job, or no one in their family has ever had a job, or they've been formally incarcerated. We don't ask any questions. That's the root of open hiring. It's an open door policy.
How did you come to work here?
Basically, after serving 4 years in state prison, I came home, I set a few goals, and I looked for employment like my first 9 months and nobody hired me because of my past. Then a friend reminded me about Grayston. I came down, put my name on a list. They called me a few days later. I came to the open hiring, to the orientation. After that, they called me 2 days later and I started working overnight.
And now you're the supervisor here?
Yes, 7 years later, I'm a supervisor, yes.
And this is the CEO of Grayston, Mike. Mike is very happy to work with us because they have been doing open hiring for 35 years and they never understood that they were very special at it. And then a couple of years ago, other companies came to them and they kept asking questions. What are you doing here? Why are you just hiring people without asking questions? And then he started talking about the story and he said, I think this is the best you can do. And then when we thought maybe we can do this also in the Netherlands, because it's not just only something you can do at Grayston at a bakery, it's something, the idea is a lot bigger, you can do it anywhere. So now Start Foundation works together with Grayston and we're introducing open hiring in the Netherlands. And we're starting with small pilots with companies that are really daring to do this with us. And we're starting with the step up jobs, so the simple jobs, but we're also looking, maybe we can pull it a little bit higher and look for different ways. Grayston started in 1982. Bernie Glassman is a Zen Buddhist, and he thought people need work, and if they have work, they can work themselves out of misery. So this is why he started the bakery. And then they met Ben and Jerry, and Ben and Jerry were very happy about the whole idea, and they said, okay, we'll put your brownies in our ice cream. So this was a big success, which was very, this was very good, because now bakery could grow and grow and grow, and now it's a big company, and they kept on hiring people by open hiring. So since a couple of years, they're also are acknowledged by this, and the White House is also inviting them to be an advisor if there are new laws and anything. So they build up their name. And now if you, tomorrow, tonight, or anytime, you're in the supermarket, anywhere, and you go for the Ben & Jerry ice, and pick the chocolate one, and you'll see Grayston on it, and every time you eat this and you buy this, you know that people get hired by open hiring. It's almost better than, anyway. Is it just opening your doors and then say, okay, everybody's welcome, just start here? No, it's not. It's just, it has a little bit more than that. It starts with the open door, but after that, you do ask questions because you want to know who's in your company. You want to know who you work with. I mean, it's your colleague, so you're interested. You want to know what are your capabilities. And how do you do, what is it really that you like to do? So you get in contact with people and you also ask questions, what is it that maybe prevents you from coming back tomorrow? Because that is what we want and what we want to know. So there are building blocks if you have if you talk about open hiring. It starts with the open door, no questions asked, just get started. The second one is the dignity doctor. And the dignity doctor can be anyone. But somebody inside of the company has to ask a question. Who are you and what is it that prevents you from coming back tomorrow? And maybe we can solve this for you. And maybe we can't, but we want to know, because if we can solve it, we're going to try to solve it for you. And this is also the American route. We don't feel sorry for you. You're not a patient. It's not that we want to help you. Dutch people always want to help everybody, like, oh, good, I can help you because it makes me feel good. No, this is not about helping. This is just about solving. You ask a question. If we can help, we do. And otherwise, it stays your own problem. But we do acknowledge it. And we all have issues. So it's not just because it's not a physical thing. It's all you can share anything you like. If you're awake at night because you have debts, because you can't pay the bill tomorrow, it's also an issue. And you have to solve it, because otherwise you feel ill, and you get ill, and you fell out. So acknowledge that people have issues. Whatever it is, we all have issues. But you only want to solve the issues that are between you and the job. Because everybody here has issues and we can solve it because we're here today. So don't solve all the issues, only the one that matters. And then it's path making. You understand that somebody starts with something, but maybe he can develop, maybe he can grow, and give him the chance to do so. And in the end, it's the open culture. The whole company has to understand that if you open the doors for anyone, everybody can walk in, and everybody should feel at home at the moment that they start. So it's not about you're special, you're here because you're open hiring. No, I'm just a person. I want to work. And, well, the last meeting, it was all about trust. It's all about trust. You trust the person that walks in, you trust that he wants to work, but the person that walks in trusts you to be a decent employer. And he has to feel safe, otherwise he won't come through your door, because then he doesn't trust you. Trust is a very, it's one of the backbones. And then suddenly everybody can walk through your door, and they're all there. So you just saw the movie from Grayston, and you see there are a lot of ex-cons working at Grayston. In the Netherlands, we have different problems. But in the Netherlands, there are also close to 1 million people sitting at home, doing nothing, feeling miserable, but they're able to work. But the trouble is that somebody else decided that they're not able to work. They always get neglected, and they don't get behind that interview. Because they're 50 years or older. If you're 50 years older, you don't get a job in the Netherlands. If you do not have a Dutch surname, which is very Dutch, but if you don't have a Dutch surname, people think, you're a foreigner, it's complicated. Let's go for number two. If your CV is not in order because you have been ill, or you have been taking care of somebody, or your diplomas are not in order, or you didn't do anything for a while, they also pick the other one. So there are a lot of people who don't get through that interview and never get into the jobs, although they really want to be there. And after 10, 20, 30 times, you think, okay, there's no place for me at the labor market, so you stop coming. And people just don't show up anymore. And there are a lot of, and this is a big group in the Netherlands. So it's not that you have to change perspective. It's not the manager or the employer who decides who fits. It's the person that shows at the door. He's the one who decides whether she or he will fit for the job. And then, is there research? Yes, there is research. And it is, we know that most of us are able to decide if you fit for the job. You don't need anybody else telling you whether you fit or not. You can do it yourself. So you just have to trust the one that shows up. Okay. Well, this is the workflow, how it works. I just talked you through it. What's more important is that we started with new companies. We started in March with the first one. This is the second one, actually. Chain Logistics opened the doors in May, and he just wants to have motivated people. He says, that's the only thing that's important for me. I don't care who walks through the door. And he also said that he was having some bias about certain people. I thought, no, I don't like her. I don't want to have her in my company. And now he had to pick number one, and after number one he had to pick number two, and after he had to pick number three, and he was like, okay, I'm not sure if this is going to work. And it worked, because people are really motivated, and they make it work, because they have to prove themselves now. Like, I think I'm capable for this job, then I'm going to prove it. And it's not because you are going to tell me that I fit, because I don't know. This is my own responsibility. So you have double motivated people. This is the other company. They just started last Wednesday, Echo Leather. Maybe it's a famous brand. You might know it. And he just wanted to hire people close in the community. And he says, I'm part of the community. I want to give back something to the community. But somehow I don't reach these people. And now he opened the doors, and he opened it last Wednesday, and 10 people already showed up at his door. You have to imagine, often you have to realize that in the Netherlands, the unemployment rate is very low. So we think that everybody has a job who wants to work at this time. And still, there are the it's not true, because he had 10. And I tell you, this is in the middle of the Netherlands, Kleiwegen. This is in Boerden. They also tried, they're really trying hard to get people, and they tried every way possible, and now they say, okay, we'll go for open hiring. Let's just do it. These are very brave employers, I have to admit. And this is the Koekfabriek. Maybe you know them, because they are also very social. They have a big social heart, which is a really nice, really nice guy. And the last one, but she's the best, I have to say. She started in March. She was the very first open hiring employer in the Netherlands. And she has more than 130 people on the waiting list already. So what happens is people walk at the door, put their name on the list, and once the job is open, they get a call. She has 130 people on a waiting list, and the job is very easy. It's basic work, and it's just a basic payment. It's not a fancy job. It's just work. So it's incredible how big this, how many people are sitting at home and they really want to work. Okay, this is the chain logistic employer, and I'll give you, you'll see a small side of what happens there.
Het enige wat de mensen vandaag hoeven doen is langskomen bij het bedrijf en hun naam en telefoonnummer op laten schrijven. Dan volgt vanzelf op volgorde van inschrijving de uitnodiging.
Ik zit nu een jaartje thuis. Ik doe wel vrijwilligerswerk. Maar ja, zet je zo aan de dijk. En het is al lastig, omdat ik op leeftijd ben, wil je toch wel weer aan een baan. Dus ja, ik dacht, dat gaan we eens mooi proberen.
Dus jullie zijn nummer 8 en nummer 9.
Voor de werkgever gaat het nieuwe concept best ver, want die is verplicht iedereen die zich inschrijft een kans te geven.
Ja, dat klopt, maar daar verwachten wij niet zoveel probleem mee. Kijk, het zijn sowieso al gemotiveerde mensen, want ze komen zelfstandig hier naartoe. En dat is iets anders dan kandidaten die via gemeente moeten.
Rob vindt het daarbij fijn om mensen die het lastig hebben een kans te geven. De nieuwelingen komen eerst hier terecht, op de assemblage.
Dus dit is gewoon een eerste periode dat wij kunnen zien wat we aan mensen hebben. Daarna zijn er gewoon mogelijkheden om als chauffeur aan de gang te gaan of in het magazijn allerlei activiteiten te doen. Dat bepaalt uiteindelijk een persoon zelf.
So this is what we are so far. I have to admit that the last three just started last week, so I haven't been able to. Echo Letter also had more than 10 people. So this morning I heard from the Koekfabriek they have 20 people on the waiting list. 20 people, which is great. So we just see and watch and we follow what's going to happen. Are the people really happy to work there? Are they going to stay? Are they able to do the job? So Start Foundation is also doing research, and we're going to stick with these employers for like a year or a year and a half. We don't know yet. And at the same time, we're trying to get more employers who also want to join us and want to see if it happens. It's just small. We start with small jobs, because just one job at a time, just to see what happens and to learn from it and to get, and hopefully we inspire other people also to do the same. And we have the other one who started. This is Corné. He was the very first person in the Netherlands hired by Open Hiring. So it's nice to meet him as well.
Mijn vrouw was op de telefoon bezig en toen kwamen die site tegen. Hey, dat is iets voor jou. Ik heb meestal erop af. Dus ik was eigenlijk de derde persoon die zijn eigen aanmeldde.
Corné van Hout zat 10 jaar lang werkloos thuis. 50 plus, moeilijk bemiddelbaar. Toen hoorde hij dat hij een baan kon krijgen als hij zijn naam bij het bedrijf op een lijstje zou zetten. Hij twijfelde geen moment.
En als eerste sta ik hier.
En zij is de werkgever die die advertentie plaatste.
Wat we erop zetten is dat we mensen willen laten weten dat ze bij ons kunnen melden. Als ze zeggen, ja, ik wil werken. En misschien zijn deze mensen al een poosje uitgesloten en daardoor moedeloos. Dat ze bij ons gewoon binnen kunnen stappen en dat ze dan recht hebben op werk.
Goedemiddag.
Corné werd aangenomen zonder vragen. Maar ja, hij moest 10 kilo kunnen tillen en het is geen zittend werk.
Het is heel lang geleden dat ik eigenlijk in een magazijn gestaan heb. Maar het is, bevalt me goed. De eerste dag had ik wel veel spierpijn.
Oh ja?
Ja, heel veel.
Ja, yeah, so this is the story of open hiring so far. And hopefully we'll have a bigger story in next year. And every employee who wants to join us, let me know. We have openhiring.nl, and you can find all the experience on that site and interviews with the employers. And so we're going to build the whole movement. It's going to be a movement. It's a movement. Thank you so much.